battling each other for pride and honour. From LA to Canada, stadiums will be smouldering as countries renew rivalries and attempt to establish themselves number one in the region. At stake is the 2002 Gold Cup, an automatic qualification to next year's World Cup finals in China. It's the Women's Gold Cup coming up next on Fox Sports World.
The nightcap to a doubleheader at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena is a good one. The defending World Cup champions, the United States, begin their qualifying journey to China 2003, taking on upstarts Mexico, which should be a very, very good match. Let's take a look at the starting 11 for the United States. Breonna Scurry back in goal. Brandi Chastain making the move to central defense. We'll see how that goes. Sobrero and Fawcett will flank her as well. Roberts, Wagner, Foudy, and Parlow in the midfield. Lily, and of course, the incomparable Mia Hamm up front. For Mexico, several players based in the United States, several players playing in college. Anise Moore plays at UCLA. She scored for Mexico against the United States in the friendly a couple weeks ago. When we come back to the Rose Bowl, we'll have the first half kickoff. Or actually, we're going to stay here for the first half kickoff. Short turnaround. The first match today in the Gold Cup. The opening fixture saw Panama get past TNT 4-2. Listen in to Julie Foudy. The Mexican national team have come a long way the last few years. Alan Hopkins alongside Tracy Milburn. I can't think of anyone better to have for this match. You play with several of these players for both the U.S. and Mexico. And for Mexico, as you mentioned earlier, they're going to have to be on top of their game. What else are you going to have to do to have success against the United States?
Well, I think they need to have their focus and intensity throughout the full 90 minutes of this match and do whatever it takes that they can to take USA out of their game, because that's what they need to do. They need to have confidence on the ball. If something goes wrong, if they get a goal scored on them, they can't get down, they can't let down, and it'll be a great game. I'm excited.
I'm excited as well. Sonia Stonencourt is our referee, and she gets the match underway. The U.S. has handled Mexico pretty handily over the years, but Mexico has been slowly closing the gap, mainly because some of their better players have been playing in college and in the WSA here. Perez, a long ball. Luis Rodriguez and Luis Berrios in Spanish. Tracy and myself, Alan Hopkins, will be here all tournament long as we figure out which two teams will qualify automatically for China 2003 and which team gets to take on the third place team from Asia. North Carolina, Tar Heel, Rennick on the throw in. Well, Coach April Heinrichs must be feeling somewhat confident. She left Shannon McMillan and Tiffany Milbert on the bench to start this one.
Yeah, it looks like she's trying to give players like Kat Reddick and Allie Wagner a chance to maybe get in the rhythm of the United States and a chance to prove that they should be in the starting lineup or at least in the fight for it.
Breonna Scurry, of course, a hero, one of the heroes for the U.S. right here at the Rose Bowl in 1999. Somewhat of a quiet year for the U.S. national team. They don't play nearly the number of matches they used to play, mainly because of WSA commitments and everyone committed to keeping the league up and running throughout the course of the season. Cross coming in.
Yeah, I know it's hard when we have players like Mia and Abby Wong back on our club team. We don't want to let them go.
Absolutely. Tracy, of course, a teammate of Mia and Abby of the Washington Freedom. You mentioned earlier, Abby, somewhat of a surprise omission, you thought, from this national team. Maybe one of the reasons is the burdens of Allie Wagner, the Santa Clara standout. Well, lead the Broncos to their first national title. There's Julie Fowdy, the captain. She's been playing for the U.S. national team since she was a teenager. They'll leave the free kick for Reddick. Left-footed ball to the other side. Kate Sobrero. Left-footed ball into the area, headed down. Mexico already in their defensive posture. It's a good move in the foul. Tiffany Roberts had a good year for Carolina. The WSA fouled by Perez.
She had a great year at Carolina. I think that's kind of what put her back on the scene for this national team.
Yeah, she definitely had fallen off the map a bit. Jennifer Molina, the goalkeeper, Mia Hamm. And a bad ball cleared away. Fawcett, still going after all these years. Fowdy plays for the San Diego Spirit, the WSA. She had a good year despite the team struggling. As I mentioned, over the years, the U.S. has really taken it to Mexico. The first meeting between these clubs back in 1991, the U.S. won 12-0. They won the next match 8-0, 9-0, then a 3-0 victory back in 99. Good work by Sobrero. Last time these clubs met in a real match, a friendly, 7-0 for the United States. Not a bad ball. Miss clearance. The shot coming in low. It takes a bad hop. And the United States strike first.
You see Allie Wagner at her best. That's what she loves. That little ball dropped back to her and all the time for just to get the shot off.
Allie Wagner has certainly gotten stronger the last couple years as well. And a good ball. Christine Lilly setting it up, and it took a bad bounce over Molina, but that might be because Wagner struck it very well. Great right-footed drive. She tucked it into the corner, and Mexico needed to keep the match close. Well, they've conceded the first goal, and gonna have to be careful the rest of the way. This one doesn't turn into one of those aforementioned routes. Fowdy wearing the captain's armband. She gets it back. She'll hold herself centrally in the midfield. The goal scorer, Wagner. Tiffany Roberts working on Patty Perez. Fowdy again moves forward. Mexico, very little possession in the early going. They could use some touches. Brandi Chastain takes it away. And we're going to get a foul. Bella Dominguez, the captain, committing the foul. Here's a goal from Wagner. Here's Reddick. Draws a pair of defenders, plays it back to Fowdy. That's a dodgy ball by Fowdy. Patty Perez read it, but she couldn't keep it in front of Roberts. So Barrow's first time ball given away. Long ball over the top. Brianna Scurry, the Atlanta beat goalkeeper, gets it away. Fowdy bypasses Wagner. Cindy Parlow gets a touch. Martha Moore. 8th minute, the United States scoring first, Allie Wagner. Taking a pass from Christine Lilly and burying it into the back of the net. Exactly what Mexico didn't want to happen. Lilly on the ball. One of the things you go up against, Tracy, as you know, these players are so experienced. Players like Lilly, Fawcett, Foudy, Ham, they've been through all the battles. You can throw in Shannon Mack's name, Tiffany Milbert's name, they're on the bench. That makes it so tough if you're Mexico, coached by Leonardo Cuellar, to really come up with a game plan to beat them. You really hope for the U.S. to make a mistake that will beat themselves.
Yeah, the U.S. has so many options that they can go to. You want to stop Mia Hamm, well then Tiffany Milbert or Allie Wagner comes through, you know, with a shot and a goal. So you can't just stop one attacking person or even defensive attacking person on this USA team. They've got so many forces and weapons that they can use.
And then when you forget about the big guns, there's players like Julie Foudy who can get you a goal from time to time. Cindy Parlow, experience as well. See April Heinrichs, far right. Shannon Mack, elbows on her knees. There's Brandi Chastain. One of the things Brandi was worried about when April asked her to move into the central defense was her ability to get forward. So certainly have to stay at home more as a central defender. She takes the throw in now.
Yeah, but as you see, she's up there. She loves to get
old
forward.
Habits are very hard to kill off, I should say, as Chastain started her career as a forward and slowly but surely gravitated toward the back line. 34 years of age, married to Santa Clara coach Jerry Smith. Of course, one of the WSA founding members. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention, of course, the great penalty kick she hit and then her impromptu goal celebration that I think was seen worldwide. I think that put sports bras on the map.
I agree.
So Mexico haven't completed too many passes. U.S. has controlled the play, is what we certainly expected. Lilly, two touches of Wagner. Foudy had it taken away in the midfield. Dominguez cuts it back. Trying to float a ball over the top. Sobrero was hiding. Fatina plays it back. A turn by Dominguez, poked away. And finally some good stuff. Gomez gives it away. Mexico keep it. Long ball to no one. We haven't seen much from your teammate Monica Girardot.
Yeah, I think that's what Mexico's lacking. They need to get Monica Girardot the ball. I think she's gonna be the leader on this Mexican team and the playmaker up top.
Speaking of playmakers, Mia Hamm, I don't know, 135 goals in her national team career. It's going to be big shoes to fill. And I don't know if the United States will have a better soccer player on the women's side, maybe even the men's side, in this generation. The throw in, Girardot with the header. Little Ernest Moron working hard defensively. Wagner trying to spring Hamm, who's battled the injury the last couple weeks, rounds, or months, or years, if I can say it. Takes a foul from Gonzalez.
It's a hard foul.
Yeah, it really was. And the injury kept Mia out of the lineup early on, and then your coach Jim Gabar brought her along slowly. popular female athletes in the world. Dangerous ball over the head of Molina. Out of play for a goal kick.
That was really dangerous, and it looks like the sun might be peeking through right there.
Here it is again. Molina went up and went over her head, and she missed the punch. Found he was in the vicinity. First time ball to Wagner. They make it look so easy to get it to the far side for Roberts. Parlow, those long legs cover so much ground. How difficult is it to defend Cindy Parlow?
Well, I guess I wouldn't know personally, but no. So yeah, her long legs are totally deceptive. I know one step and she's past
you. She's past you. Strong physical player. Another North Carolina alum. Although that's changing, and used to be all North Carolina on the national team for so many years. A header heading toward Molina. She had to stay at home. But the women's game has really grown across the board. College players popping up everywhere. And the best players don't go to North Carolina anymore necessarily. States sitting back, and the unforced error will give possession on the throw-in back to the U.S. 15th minute, Allie Wagner has the only goal. Mexico been holding strong since, trying to keep this scoreline in reach. Susie Mora. Mora again wins the first ball. Wagner, good first touch. Pam keeping it simple. Playing her back to goal. Here's Foudy. She'll play the way she's facing. Here's Reddick. Challenge bravely. Foudy. Ham again. Moore just gets it away. Christine Lilly plays for the Boston Breakers. I think Christine Lilly is the all-time male or female leader in international caps. I believe this is 241. Long range shot. No problem at all for Molina. Hiddies, looked like she got her hand up there. Play on. Sobrero very fast, make sure it goes over the inline. Manny Perez has seen a lot of the action on the left. Siri Molnix temporarily displaced Brianna Scurry, the number one goalkeeper for the U.S. I think it's still pretty early in terms of World Cup talk, but those two will be battling it out, and I think April Heinrichs has a good dilemma. Both Scurry and Molinix. Roberts decides on Parlow, gets it back. Brown. Reddick, a couple options on the overlap. It's Lilly who makes the run. Working on Morris, he's tripped up from behind by Valderrama.
I love watching Lily play. She just is all over the place. She makes overlapping runs. She's everywhere, and she makes her teammates around her look so good. Not that they aren't.
Still something very difficult to do at this level. The ball coming in. Great save by Molina.
I think that was Julie Foudy on the end of that.
Mia Hamm with the free kick. And you're absolutely right. Great save by Molina denying Foudy. She's been hanging around the back post a couple times we've seen. See how far back the U.S. is dropping, allowing the defenders of Mexico to build the attack, and that's why Moore with a poor touch. Ham! Scored as many goals as she has the green light to have a go anytime she wants. What's it like playing with Mia Hamm, Tracy?
It's great. She's such a phenomenal player, and you really do learn something every day at practice from her. She is a great teacher and a great, obviously a great player of the game, and it's just great.
There it is again.
Not enough I could say about her.
Hamm looking for Foudy. It actually hit off the post. We were talking earlier, Mia can be a bit demanding on all of her teammates. But how was the last couple of years? Because she hasn't really played that much, not nearly as much as your club had hoped she would. But how has she been able to stay fit and stay sharp?
Well, I think coming back this year after her injury, she was focused and she was sharp. She was ready to play and she was fit. It took her a little while to be able to play 90 minutes, but even though she wasn't playing 90 minutes towards the end of the season, she could go for a full 90 if she wanted to. And it's been great having her there and obviously learning as much as I can and getting as much as I can from her.
We'll leave it for Monica Gonzalez. Fawcett to Foudy. The two San Diego Spirit teammates hook up. Foudy gives it away. Here's Denise Mora. She can't find Valderrama. Riddick wins it. Long ball over the head of Parlo. That's certainly her game. She's a good target player. Long way to go for that pass, and we're going to get a foul.
One against Tiff Roberts again. She is tiny, 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 but she's always in the battle, always in the. You know, the heat of the match. She's tough. She definitely does not act like she's about 5'4".
Tiffany, a member of the Carolina Courage. I know you're going to hate me for saying this, but the team that got past your team in the Founders Cup.
Yeah.
But you'll get them next time.
Yeah.
Good story. Carolina going from worst to first. And I like the fact that they only have the only woman coach in the entire WSA, Coach McDermott. She was able to guide her club from the pole house to the penthouse. Halfway through this first half, the United States still hanging on to this one goal lead given to them by Allie Wagner. certainly one of the favorites to win the World Cup in China next fall, but they want to make sure they get there. Certainly can't take qualifying for granted. Seems like, Tracy, the U.S. content to clog up the midfield when Mexico have the ball and let the defenders, who don't seem to be too good on the ball, start the attack, and it's worked out very well for them so far.
Yep, that's exactly right. They're letting their defense kind of play around with it in hopes that they make a mistake, and they obviously have sometimes, and that's what U.S. is hoping for.
Yep. Ground closed down quickly by Chastain. Foudy there as well. We get a whistle, and this foul favoring the U.S. The captain Dominguez doesn't seem to disagree too much. Flicked on, but out of the reach of Parla. This month, the U.S. won the U.S. Women's Cup, winning past Italy in the final. The U.S. finished that tournament with a perfect 3-0 record. Italy actually played them very, very tough until the U.S. exploded for 4 goals in 15 minutes in the second half to pull away. Parlo building up, head full of steam, popped it forward. Molina making the grab and taking the foul. Short. And going down, looking for the foul. It doesn't come. The referee, this is Denencourt, shakes her head. Doesn't think there was a foul there. I'm sure Mia disagrees. They get a whistle this time. Allie Wagner tripped up. Dina committing the foul. Ham will leave it for Redick. Redick gives it back to Ham. He looked at Leonardo Cuellar. Able to keep in that ball. Sobrero looking for Roberts again. It finds her. Roberts met by Gonzalez. And it'll be a corner kick. Or actually, it's been changed. The assistant referee pointed to the corner, but it's a goal kick. But on East Mora. One of my wife's student athletes at UCLA, and my wife loves her. Denise already endearing herself to Westwood life. It's a good run by Sobrero. She stays in front of it and caroms some more. First time left for the ball, gets it away, but near the center circle, the U.S. reclaim possession. Poked away by Valderrama in front of Lilly. Bowdy looking for Ham. Aguilar played professionally in the United States, where he's lived for latter portions of his life. He's played for the San Diego Sockers in the old MISL and NASL. Been the technical director for Mexico since 1998. Mexico, of course, qualified for its first FIFA Women's World Cup in 1999, having to win a playoff with South American runner-up Argentina. Mora trying to hold it. Wearing the white boots. Half an hour at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. The first match for both these clubs in Group 1. Panama already has 3 points, beating TNT 4-2 in the opening match of this twin build today. That's Sunday in October. Just like that, we're already in the month of November. And maybe, Tracy, had this tournament taken place closer to the end of the WSA season, the U.S. players would be a bit tired, but a little bit of a break probably has had a little pep in their step.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of these players have gotten a little refreshed.
Ham can't curl it in. Inside the final 15 minutes, U.S. has played almost exclusively in this half of the field. Here's Wagner. Can't cut it back in front of Valderrama. Nicole Heinrichs took over for Tony DiCicco, former coach of the women's program, the University of Virginia. Safe to say she was a pretty good player in her day. The U.S. tactics proven to be the difference is no one in the midfield for Mexico has really got any sort of rhythm. Here's Roberts trying to slip it through. Maybe not the best option. Molina has it in her hands. So we've seen Mexico being forced to build out of the back. They haven't been able to do it. So what do they do now?
I think they need to keep coming forward. Their defenders need to keep moving the ball forward until the USA step up and pressure them. They're actually sending long balls when they don't need to, and no one's really pressuring them.
That's a good point. They have a lot of time on the ball when they're giving it away as well. Maybe Mexico can get a little bit more in the way of possession if they take a couple more touches. It's Monica Girardo, starred at the University of Notre Dame. Finally something going forward. Reddick able to hold off Dominguez. And Kat, the 20-year-old, playing her 21st match for the U.S. One two college kids in the starting 11. Allie Wagner's got the only goal, the other. I'm sure both of those players eager to do well for the U.S., but get back to their college teams. Again, another long ball given away without any pressure. Monica Gonzalez. Now Dominguez. Good double team. And we haven't seen too much of the U.S. defense because Mexico hadn't had too much possession. You see what happens as soon as they get into the flanks, the double team came. Showed too much of the ball. I mean, that's why they're content to play long balls. He takes a hack on Wagner. No call. More port clearance. Harlow and Ham trying to combine. Roberts mixing it up as well. A trio of Tar Heels finally finds Fowdy. Ham on her left foot. She's not afraid to use it. A good header. Well, it seems like Christine Lilly shows up just about everywhere.
That was a great ball by Mia.
We know Mia can finish with the best of them. She is the best of them, let's face it. But she's a very good striker of the ball. It was an excellent ball. Minutes ago in the first half. Mexico playing themselves slowly into the match. Beginning to make inroads in the midfield, but I don't think Brianna Scurry has had too much action at all. Gomez, a little bit of what you're talking about, carrying the ball. Now they get it through. Dominguez can't hold it. Chastain over the head of Wagner. Moore, just looked a little shaky with those touches. Wagner again, good early ball. Here's Parla. She winds out. Knocked out of play by Valderrama. Throw in is headed over the end line by Valderrama, and the U.S. have a corner.
She'll probably be looking for Parlo in there.
Bounty's gotten to an end of a couple good long balls as well. She was lurking. Ball back in, head away by Monica Gonzalez. She's made her presence felt defensively for Mexico. Here's Ham. Great through ball. Lilly inside the area, back looking for Wagner, but there's Valderrama. Mexico beginning to play better. Mora just gets it upfield looking for Dominguez. She turns, she's able to hold off Rennick. Here comes some help defensively in the form of Sobrão. Mexico weathered the early storm, sorry Tracy, and now they're playing much better.
I was just going to comment on Dominguez. You can tell that she really likes to take it at the player and likes to be physical. So her and Rettick will make a good matchup.
Yeah, I think so. Cat wins it there. Knocked away. finds a white jersey. Chastain cleans up the long ball. Scurry hasn't gotten a touch in a while. She'll keep it at her feet. It looks like Brianna Scurry has gotten herself in even better shape. This shot coming in, no problem at all.
Yeah, I think she's looking great. Yep. She's probably the best I've ever seen her look.
I absolutely agree, and I think maybe with your teammate Sari Mullenix taking some time away from her, maybe grounded her a bit, got her refocused.
Yeah, I agree. She probably knows what she has to do in order to play.
Perez lost her footing, but she was able to find Susie Moore. Jennifer Molina getting ready. Wagner and Ham standing over this free kick. It'll be Ham. Clips it in, looking for Parlow. She got a foot to it. It hits the top of the bar. Stays out of play for a goal kick. And there's the height advantage in that long reach of Parlow.
Yeah, those long legs. Just when you think it's going to go out, they get to the ball.
Like she popped it up and over the goal and it hit the top of the bar. Molina was on the ground, just hoping that it went over the goal, and it did.
Dowdy hoping it didn't.
Yeah, she was right there pressuring. Dowdy's covered a lot of ground in the early going. Here's Monica Girardo. Touches have been few and far between for her. Oh, she gets it through. Moore committed. She didn't win. And here's Lily racing toward the box. Oh, a great little flick. Still alive. Roberts looking for some help. Wagner. Parlow had a quick look at it. Bounty keeps it. Parlow. Wagner to the far side for Roberts. And she took a look up before the ball came to her. Lost track of it. Give me a goal kick. If you're Mexico, considering your poor start to this match, you have to be somewhat relieved that U.S. has only scored once. And at this point in the half, you would think Mexico will try to stay at home and not give U.S. a two-goal lead. Another shaky clearance, but it finds Gonzalez. Ham, hard step over, plays it back. Down by Valderrama, but only as far as Lily. Poked away by Valderrama, but look at Kat Reddick. Lily, one more for Kat. Kat right-footed ball. There's a player there, and it's Mia Hamm. She pounds the turf in disgust, but she had to come a long way to get to the end of it.
Mia is such a perfectionist. She knows that she should have had that. Should have had that one.
The thing is, she's had that one several times before. I'm sure she scored just about every goal imaginable. Here's Ham on the ground. 2-0, Parlow, an easy finish. And Mexico, the defensive lapse just before halftime, gives the U.S. a two-goal lead.
Goal for USA by number 12, Cindy Parlow.
Here's Mia just trying to do what she can to get the ball in the dangerous zone, and it slips through right to Parlow and just walks it in.
Great run by Lily. She takes the defender with her, and little cover. And Parlow just walked right into that goal. I don't know if she'll get an easier goal in this tournament. The 53rd goal for the U.S. first half winding down. Allie Wagner opened the scoring for the U.S. Cindy Parlow adding the next. And the U.S. in complete control as half number one. It's coming to an end. Make sure you join us. Highlights from the first match, the 2002 Women's Gold Cup between Panama and TNT. Coming up at halftime. Parlo working on Gonzalez. That's a good match. You see how small Moore is next to Parlo. Molina, slow off her line. Where she's been perched. Makes the play. Goal again. Ham played a great ball. Molina couldn't come up with it at the near post. And the U.S. will make you pay. I think April Heinrichs will be quite happy how the first half has gone for the U.S. And Mexico are going to have to make some adjustments during the half to somehow get back in it.
Yeah, I think if you're Mexico, you're going to have to talk about how your defense is going to be able to provide offense for your team when the U.S. is sitting back. I think they need to adjust and make changes for that so they can produce offense and get more.
It's almost as if the U.S. is giving everyone a taste of their own medicine. The U.S. always accustomed to playing teams who play that style, sitting back.
I think Mexico kind of wasn't expecting this.
Yep. Well, I think, too, with the U.S. just getting past Mexico in a friendly, maybe Mexico felt like they had what it takes to beat the U.S. 1 minute's been added on. We're nearly halfway through that. Roberts had it poked away, but the U.S., I think, turned it up a notch from the beginning. Mexico paying the price for their sluggish start. Here's Lily. Things in a good corner. Molina, that's the batted away. Wagner puts it right back into the danger. Wagner blocked. Dominguez, there's Sobrero. Great organization by the U.S. on that counter. And we have played one half of action at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. Well, we saw in our first match of this doubleheader an upset. That doesn't look like it's going to happen here. The U.S. on top, 2-0. We'll be back with all the halftime happenings after the break.
How would you like to have the thrill of your favorite theme park ride right in your own home? Well, now you can actually experience a totally new dimension on your own computer. It's called Extreme 3D, and it's like nothing you've ever seen before. X3D's radical new award-winning technology makes the images actually jump right out of the screen. With X3D, see movies, DVDs, and home videos like you've never seen them before. You can even turn your own pictures and videos into three dimensions. Improve your kids' grades with amazing three-dimensional educational CDs. Hook your TV up through your PC and watch sporting events in the third dimension. All the games you now own can be played in Extreme 3D. That's right. X3D turns your existing game collection into a virtual reality experience. Supercharging your PC has never been easier. Look, just plug the virtual reality converter between the screen and the computer, and you've given your computer the ultimate upgrade for the most incredible viewing experience ever. And now, for a limited time, you can get the entire X3D system for just 10 low payments of $9.95. Look at all you're getting. The virtual reality converter and installation software. This transforms all of your flat images into new three-dimensional experiences. Plus, you get the conversion software that gives you everything you need to view three-dimensional photos, videos, movies, and games. and you'll also get one pair of revolutionary X3D viewing glasses. Order right now and we'll include 15 exciting games. They're all free when you order X3D today. Look, you get everything, a total value of over $800 for just 10 easy payments of $9.95. This offer won't last, so call right now.
Call 1-800-756-4774. X3D has a 30-day money-back guarantee, less shipping and handling. So if X3D isn't the best home 3D system you've ever seen, just send it back. No questions asked. Call 1-800-756-4774. That's 1-800-756-4774.
England has the Premier League. Austria has Aussie rules. USA, the NFL. And Canada, the CFL. Three downs, 12 men, 110 yards, 20-yard end zone, and one purpose, to win the Grey Cup Championship. The Canadian Football League, this Saturday on Fox Sports World. For the true soccer fan, it's not only important how the game is played, but where. Fox Sports World takes you to those historical venues where legendary matches continue to be played.
Bombonera, Azteca, Maracaná, Highbury, El Campín, Old Trafford, Monumental de Nunes.
The greatest stadiums in the world, brought to you as only Fox Sports World knows how. Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
The USA on top of Mexico after 45 minutes of play from the Rose Bowl. 2-0. And the U.S. started fast. Allie Wagner getting the goal in minute 5. Cindy Parlow adding another one 2 minutes from time. The first match of the 2002 Women's Gold Cup featured Panama and TNT. And early on, the shot coming in from St. Louis. In a minute 29. Bedoya, up and over, Ramixson, a good goal. Ramixson paid the price for aggressive play, and Mantezina, Bedoya scores the first goal for Panama in the tournament. Great finish in the end, minute 35, a defensive mistake, and introducing 17-year-old Venom Amarelius Damera. Chad, an outstanding match.
Right here, defensive mistake, and just capitalizes on it and puts Trinidad on the board.
Yeah, it really wasn't anything fancy from Johnson, although it was a fairly difficult finish. Franco almost got to it. So 2-1 was the score at halftime. We fast forward to the second half. TNT playing with just 10 when Damera roofs that shot, her second goal of the match.
It's a rocket, just up to Reeve. Beautiful shot.
It really was, and then just 3 minutes later, the ball coming in to Lewis. A free header. She had to convert, and she did, and it was 3-2.
Perfect cross. Just backs up a few steps and heads it just under the post.
The Soca Divas were in trouble. Minute 75. Damera, the first hat trick of the tournament. Pounding her chest, a great, great match for Damera. A great result for Panama. And Panama cruise to the 4-2 victory and claim all 3 points and sit on top of Group 1, but the U.S. is closing in. We'll be back with highlights and stats from half number one between the U.S. and Mexico. After the break, you're watching Fox Sports World.
This shot for the cup and a piece of hurling history. What must be going through that young man's head? Has he got what it takes to be a champion? Champion.
My son Jerome and I I'm making sure everyone in Pittsburgh is eating good.
The bus.
We bought you some nice hot chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Chicken Noodle, loaded with big hearty noodles and chunks of tasty chicken. More chicken than before.
Want a bowl of frame?
Yeah, try.
Go for it.
Could I get your son's number?
Sure. 36.
Campbell's Chunky Chicken Noodle fills you up right.
Here's your forecast. 63 degrees with scattered showers throughout the day.
All right. Hey, we got Chad coming in from Wall Street. Chad, what's happening out in the market?
The S&P is trading at heavy volume as the Dow is up and the NASDAQ is up.
Looks like everything's looking up today. We got Chopper John coming in with a traffic report. Chopper John!
Jim, you want to board the Oldville Parkway?
I love Chopper John.
When you can do all this and more with a wireless phone, that's M-Life from AT&T Wireless. Your mobile life made better.
I've always loved working on computers, and in the Army, that's what I do.
If you never thought about the U.S. Army or Army Reserve, think about this. There are 212 ways for you to become a soldier and work at a job you'll love. Call for this free video to find out which job is right for you. And if you call 1-800-645-ARMY right now, you'll also receive a free Army t-shirt with your video. Discover the 212 ways you can be an Army of One.
The 19th Central American and Caribbean Games take place in a revitalized El Salvador, November the 22nd through December the 7th. The passion of century-old rivalries will be recreated on soccer fields, volleyball and basketball courts, boxing rings and baseball diamonds to crown the champions of Central America and the Caribbean. A new El Salvador awaits, a competition with a history second only to the Olympics. The Central American and Caribbean Games, November the 22nd through December the 7th, on pay-per-view and closed circuit.
La Liga, Spain's internationally renowned soccer league, comes to you exclusively on Fox Sports World. La Liga features a collection of elite soccer greats, such as Zidane, Ronaldo, Riquelme, Roberto Carlos, Figo, and Raul. Real Madrid and FC Barcelona are only two of the many great teams that play here on Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
Mexico had to play nearly perfect in half number one if they were going to beat the U.S. They didn't get it done. And the United States made them pay, scoring twice in half number one to take an early lead in this one. First half highlights. Lily, minute 5 to Allie Wagner. Great finish, Tracy.
Yeah, Christine Lily is able to just drop it back to Allie Wagner. Allie Wagner just makes sure she gets it on target and low, and it goes in.
Nice strike from Wagner. Good balance. Struck it well. More from the U.S. Roberts trying to spin. Didn't look good that time, but the U.S. would nearly get another goal. Fowdy hitting the post. It looked originally like Molina had kept it out, but upon further inspection, she didn't know much about it. In minute 43, we're talking about Mexico trying to keep this a one-goal lead, and look what happens. CP. Oh, she doesn't even celebrate. It's that easy scoring goals.
Yeah, Mia just tries to get in the danger zone, like I said, and slips through, and Cindy Parlo is able to walk it in.
It really was. And Tracy, we look at the first half stats, and look at that number that jumps out. The U.S. 10 shots to Mexico's 1. In 45 minutes of play. So the U.S. has a two-goal lead halfway to their opening group victory in the 2002 Gold Cup. We'll see what they do in the second half, which we'll have for you after the break. Stay with us.
You've seen lots of slicers and dicers, but nothing works like a spirulie. It's the quickest, easiest way there is to cut just about any vegetable. The sturdy suction legs hold securely to your kitchen counter. Just insert your vegetable and away you go. The spirulie works like magic on a potato. Just turn the crank and shred perfect hash browns. Now change blades and you have those curly fries that everyone loves. Change blades again and you can make great homemade potato chips. The spirulie holds a whole cabbage so you can make a mountain of coleslaw. Slice peppers and onions just the way you want them. Shred tomatoes for great homemade salsa. And make beautiful garnishes, too. To change blades, simply pull one out and snap another one in. The blades you're not using, store conveniently in this built-in holder. You get the amazing Spirulli, complete with all three blades for only $19.95. But wait, call now and get these genuine Schmidt and Bauer knives absolutely free through this special TV offer. Each blade is precision crafted from quality imported high carbon stainless steel. You get this 13-inch chef's knife that's sure to become your very favorite. You also get a 13-inch carving knife that makes cutting meat and poultry a joy. Plus a 10-inch fillet knife, a 9-inch utility knife, and a 7.5-inch paring knife. You'll also receive this carbon steel sharpener, plus this dishwasher safe cutting board and handsome molded gift case. The complete set is yours free when you order the Spirulli. That's right, through this special TV offer, you get everything for only $19.95. So have your credit card ready and order now.
Call 1-800-269-8523 now to order your Spirulli. Order now, and you'll also receive as our gift a 5-piece set of Schmidt & Bauer knives, knife sharpener, cutting board, and gift case absolutely free. Call now, 1-800-269-8523.
A way of expressing. A way of interpreting. A way of life. The Scottish Premier League is on display. As 12 teams render their souls while defending their pride to become the new king in the league that defines champion spirit. The Scottish Premier League on Fox Sports World, your home of world-class soccer. You are not alone. The passion is explained with little or no words. Argentinian soccer, only on Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
The players returning for half number two at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, the United States. On top, 2-0 over Mexico. Mexico has been closing the gap on the United States over the years, but so far the gap is 2 goals in this first group match for both of these clubs. Alan Hopkins alongside Tracy Milburn. So glad you could join us as we begin this long march to China 2003. Some substitutions for both clubs. It looks like coming in is Yanet Antonez for Mexico. Sonia Denencourt, our referee. She gets set to get half number two underway. Mexico chasing 2 goals as the United States start with the ball in the lead. Well, Tracy, we talked a little bit about what Mexico needs to do in terms of becoming a little bit better on the ball. What does the U.S. have to do to maintain this 2-goal advantage?
I think they need to just keep on doing what they're doing. I mean, they're playing great and they're controlling most of the play here, and they just need to, with the players coming in, they need to bring in new players so they can gain confidence too. I think April, we're going to see that later with April, you know, bringing in people off the bench, and that's about it. I mean, they're up 2-0, so there's nothing.
It's an easy halftime speech to give if you're April Heinrichs. Even if you're nitpicking and really trying to break down this U.S. performance, very hard to find fault with what they did in the first half. Defensively, they were great. Offensively, solid as always, scoring twice. The effort has been there. And I think they are quickly proving that they're still the class of the region. Although on the other side of the bracket is Canada, and they certainly will have something to say about that. Mexico going to have some work to do. If they don't somehow scratch out a result here, they will be third, maybe even last, depending on goal difference, behind TNT in the four-team group. Cindy Parlow tripped up by Monica Girardo, who's seen better days, certainly in the first half. Good little move by CP. Lily's cross. Out of play. Angela Huklins has checked in. Another fringe player getting a chance to solidify their spot to the national team. Gonzalez, very busy for a tab, putting out several fires. Just knocks this one out of play. Angela making only her seventh appearance with the national team, also plays for the Boston Breakers in the WUSA. Annie Perez there defensively. Parlow looking for Wagner. Gonzalez, good ball to Perez. Hoopley's wins it. Little step over, and Cindy Parlow shut it down. No way she could get to that one. Tracy, got to think there's a lot of pressure on some of these bench players for the U.S. A player like Hoopley's who comes in and somewhat of an unknown player, and you want to keep the level of play at the level it was. You don't want to be the one clearing weak spot.
Yeah, I agree. Coming into that situation, she's just got to, you know, maintain what the player that she came in for did and show her stuff.
Yep.
Prove herself.
You want to certainly play with the pressure, learn to play with the pressure, but also remain relaxed and poised. Also try not to try too hard. And as we said in the first game, it's really all about fun. A little bit. I don't want my kids getting the wrong idea.
And winning. But usually if you win, you have fun.
Absolutely. First 5 minutes of the second half, Mexico unable to dent this two-goal lead by the United States. It'll be interesting to see how many changes April makes in this half. I think the U.S. is as comfortable as you can be with a two-goal lead. Hoopleys. That was a very enterprising run down the right. 24-year-old.
Yeah, she had a little bit of space on the wing there, and she maybe took a touch slightly too far outside, and that's why her shot went wide.
And hit the referee in front of Wagner. Foot race. Won by Hoopleys, and it'll be a throw-in.
I think I'm starting to see already the United States changing their tactic and kind of more pressuring up top and giving the Mexican defenders a little different look than they had the first half.
A
they're not given as much time to pass the ball around or to send the long ball in.
I mean, that's one of the adjustments Abel Heinrichs made at halftime, because we certainly saw the Mexican defenders had a lot of time on the ball to make good decisions, but they didn't. A lot of errant passes out of the back. Really forced the Mexico defense to spend a lot of time defending more than they wanted to. Well, here's Ham. Look at unselfishness. That shot blocked by Gonzalez. She's probably been the lone bright spot in the tricolor defense.
Looked like Lily was trying to get it back to me on that.
Carlo again, a target. Look for Fowdy. Chastain has worked herself forward. Carlo making a near post run. Molina has to go overhead again. Euclides kept it on her left foot. It was blocked. This is going to start a counter. Dominguez. That's a good ball into the space. The first time the U.S. defense has been caught flat-footed. And there's a good run. Antunes making a great effort. Second half substitution. Came on at halftime. Fowdy kind of poked away. Dominguez, Gerardo to the other side. Valderrama battling, cuts it inside, but Kat Reddick is there. He's tough to take off the ball. Chastain bouncing it forward for Ham, trying to hold it. Looking at the referee, no call. Dominguez, it's a delightful left-footed ball, but it's going to run out of real estate. Looking for Patty Perez. One thing you can say about Mexico, they have not given the United States an inch. They played extremely hard so far, despite the scoreline not in their favor. Gerardo played a good first-time ball to Perez. She couldn't hold it.
I think that's one thing we all know, is Mexico's not going to back down.
Yep. Chastain can play with either foot. Gonzalez, exquisite first touch. She's beginning to really find a good rhythm. Gerardo. Here's Gonzalez taking some space. Bounty. Help get the U.S. off to a great start. Has it taken away from behind, and see Antunes in her blind spot. Ham, a long first touch. Ties it up with her second touch to Reddick. Carlo foul from behind. Anakin Gonzalez, I think, for at least for my money, has been the best player for Mexico in the match so far. Problem is, she's a defender, and they're down a pair of goals. Fowdy. Good early ball. Shots, and that one way out of play. Gonzalez keeps it simple. Taken away by Mia Hamm. As you were alluding to earlier, the U.S. stepping up the pressure. But here's a good chance. Dominguez. Fawcett closing her down, applying the pressure. The Mexico captain finding some space. The second time we've seen the U.S. defense caught a bit flat.
Yeah, they got caught there on the counterattack. Mia Hamm was up pressuring. They might have thought and anticipated her winning the ball. Mexico got a good chance out of it.
Deanna Scurry played her college ball at University of Massachusetts, led them to a Final Four in her college days. Bad ball in two white jerseys there. Antonus, who came on for Elise Mora at halftime. Made a couple good runs so far.
I think Mexico could have had a little more people forward for that.
Yeah. You would certainly think they'd be committed to increasing their numbers in the area. Wagner on the free kick. Wants to play it long, leaves it short for Hamm. Here's Reddick, all kinds of time and space. Now she's closed down by Valderrama. And the pressure forces the errant pass. That shot deflected. Molina did well to track it and knock it away.
Great change of pace by Heathley. Got the shot off and it deflected. Just missed the outside of the goal.
Yep, Heathley has added a little bit different dimension since she's come on. Touch by Dominguez, but there was Sobrero, very fast, playing as the last person back that time. Mexico looked very dangerous on the counterattack. It's almost as if the U.S. is pushing up too much at times, trying to get that third goal. I'm sure the most important thing to April Heinrichs at this point is getting the clean sheet. Gerardo, one of your teammates, as we've mentioned earlier, what makes Monica such a good player, Tip?
Well, she likes to definitely change the point of attack for the team, and she's a good central target. She's got good size and can hold the ball well.
Help put Notre Dame soccer on the map. Throwing right in front of their bench.
There's Susie Mora. We played against her a lot at USC, our rival school.
Everyone's rival school. Actually, the Lady Bruins of UCLA taking on USC today in a crosstown match. Most of those teams playing very well. Soccer very much a part of the women's game, especially for both of these countries. Lily looked like she took a bad step there and looked like she came up limping for a moment, but seems to be okay. We played 1 hour here at the Rose Bowl, late afternoon giving way to early evening thanks to the time change. The lights beginning to take hold. Really, it's been the United States who've had a hold of Mexico. Goal in the fifth minute by Wagner set them on their way. Cindy Parlow added another 2 minutes before halftime. He's on the ball now, working on Gonzalez. Little hesitation and go. She gets off her cross. Euclides lurking. Euclides winning it from behind. Ham on the tackle. Euclides for Wagner, operating on the right. Cross in, low on the ground. The dummy! Ham couldn't get it. Parlo was there as well. Offside, but a fantastic sequence for the United States. They very nearly had a third goal.
Yeah, it looked like Parlo could have got there, but she kind of hesitated a minute because she saw Mia coming straight for it.
And here's the play that led to the onside call. So Shannon Mack will come in for Cindy Parlo. Shannon McMillan, standout at the University of Portland. Standout for the San Diego Spirit. Remember the 99 Women's World Cup winning sign? Sydney 2000 Olympian, although a lot of these girls don't like to talk about that one too much since they lost to Norway and had to settle for silver. But that's the thing about this U.S. team. They are so deep. You take out Parlo, who's already got a goal, and you bring in Shannon Mack, who's going to be goal hungry. No rest for the weary Mexico defense. Euclides is really... come in for Tiffany Robertson, played well. Good hold there. With a good physical presence. Fowney. Out of the reach of Shannon Mack. She's trying to find her San Diego Spirit teammate. Looking around like I didn't do anything. And the medical staff of the United States will come on, undercutting Sobrero, and she landed pretty hard right on her back. Couldn't get her arms out to brace her fall, and certainly hope she's okay. Sobrero also played at the University of Notre Dame. Sobrero is okay. I think it's going to take a lot more than that to get her out of this match. So after the short stoppage, Fawcett stands over the free kick. Gonzalez heads away at the edge of the arc. The first time volley, ambitious. Mia Hamm, the only one with the gumption to try that one. I'm sure you've seen her hit some pretty amazing shots in practice.
Yep. Got them all.
Yep. It's always good when you're on her small-sided team, isn't it?
Exactly.
Lead by Ham, likes to play simple with her back to goal. Euclides making that pass from Wagner work out. Strong, absorbing the first challenge. Wagner quickly comes in support. A 1-2. Wagner, little feint. Left-footed ball. The flag should be up offside, and it is on Shannon McMillan.
That was a great ball by Adley Wagner just to get that through. I don't know how she got that through.
And you see Shannon Mack just floating past the last defender. Give the Mexican defense credit that time. Fawcett to Fowdy. Fowdy, you know she's looking for Shannon Mack. It's amazing to me, having called games for the San Diego Spirit the past couple years in the WSA, that they haven't done better with McMillan, Fowdy, and Fawcett. Those three are key members of this U.S. national team, but it just hasn't translated to the club level. I guess it goes to show you need more than a couple players to have success.
Yeah, I know that they're making a couple changes there.
And they got a new coach, new general manager, and trying to make the playoffs.
Trying to figure out that, too, that question of why aren't they doing so well.
Bowdy. Mia Hamm, good overlapping run. Sobrero had to wait. She seems okay after taking that knock in the fall, but you wouldn't know about that cross. So Monica Girardo has seen her match come to an end. 68 minutes of work. Monica Vergara comes in. Second substitution for Leonardo Cuellar, the Mexico coach. Patty Perez mixing it up with Huclis.
It's a good battle.
Yeah, it was a good battle. Both players playing hard. Here's Gonzalez just inside the United States half. Not a bad ball in behind the defense. Brianna Scurry some work. She hasn't had much to do, which is usually the case when the U.S. plays. Shannon Mack lays it off first time. That's a good ball in behind the defense. Lily, Shannon Mack in support. She has a heavy right footed shot. Turned away by Molina.
Shannon McMillan.
Shannon Mack.
She can hit it from anywhere.
Yeah, she really can. She might be the best ball striker on this team. She just takes a settling touch. Pulls the trigger. Long range effort. Good save by Molina. He's actually turning in a pretty respectable performance in the Mexico goal. U.S. still unable to get a goal in this half. Molina again. Sees that one go over her head. Chastain was the closest to it.
Chastain loves that ball right there. She was just a little late getting to it.
Look at the strike. Can't hit it much better. And Molina, good save. Good positioning allowed her to keep it out. 70th minute. Mexico making the U.S. sweat. Poor goal kick. Can they capitalize? Shannon Mack sliding in. It's those kind of mistakes that Mexico are going to have to clean up in their game. You just can't have that. Poor goal kicks. It's almost inexcusable at this level. Good check to the ball. Poked away by Wagner. Hamm giving chase. Actually, Shannon Mack, excuse me. Hamm is square. Doesn't come to Molina. She didn't want to use her left foot. Right footed clearance finds Vergara. He gets her first look at the ball. Chastain, a long header back, and Brianna Scurry gets it. Curls it out to the far side. Kat Reddick outside of the right foot ball. It's a good one. Here's Hamm working on Moore. Lost her balance, gets on her feet. She draws three white jerseys and ends up giving it away. But she did the right thing and tried to playing it out on that triple team. Huclis, first time ball. Moore stabs at it, controls. Plays it out. Bowdy wins it. Vergara's there. That's where Mexico have had the most success in this half. Fawcett, a poor ball back. But Dominguez hasn't been able to take her chance.
Dominguez had a chance to pull the trigger, but Fowdy did great to track back.
She really did. She was in the midfield a moment earlier.
Is that Fowdy or Fawcett? Fawcett?
Fawcett tracking back, and Fawcett didn't really get anything on that header. Dominguez. Lots of clean ball back. Fatina. can't hold it. And it finds Mia Hamm. Shannon McMillan release. Touch inside. Oh!
She just tried to bend the ball there with the outside of her right foot. Just missed.
Trying to catch Melina cheating. April Heinrichs looks on. Tell you what, she didn't miss by much, did she?
Nope. I think she had her beat, though. If she took another touch inside, she could have.
I think she could have cut inside as well. Look at Coach Heinrichs. A Colorado native like myself. Pouty. Long ball to the other side. Knocked away, but the U.S. will keep it on the throw-in. Riddick couldn't find it. It's a good little move around Wagner, but Wagner says thank you very much. It played it forward. Now Hamm. Hamm pulling away. Gonzalez, good control. And we're going to get a foul and a yellow card. Valderrama trying to figure out why. It's actually the first card of the match. Okay. Two in the wall for Mexico. It'll be Hamm. Raises her hand. That starts the runs. Put away by Fatina at the edge of the six. Wagner kept it momentarily. More. To Valderrama. They give it away. Kat Reddick will go back to Brandi Chastain. Chastain, good move. Now what's she gonna do with it? Keeps her head, plays Fawcett. Sobrero, across midfield, she wants to play it long. Over the head of Mia Hamm. Great move by Lily. She's running like it's the first minute of the game. Hits the post! Stays in play, Shannon Mack gets it again. Her cross deflected over the end line for a corner.
Christine Lilly had no angle there.
Yeah, she really didn't.
Slipped it through and just hit the post.
Just missing. Molina was beaten. So Shannon Mack will take the corner as we get another Mexico substitution. Low on the ground. Orbis, the player that has come on. Third substitution for Coach Cuellar. Patty Perez, a frustrated push from the back on Allie Wagner. April Heinrichs has brought in Shannon McMillan and Angela Huclis. The substitution she's has made. Bounty, she is really the fulcrum in the midfield. She keeps it moving from side to side. She gets it again. Knocks an easy ball to Kat Reddick. Kat finding herself in advanced position, plays Hamm, first time ball. Not very good, but Lily makes up for it. Can't say enough about Christine Lilly's effort. Mia Hamm making more fall. And Molina off her line. Vergara. Dominguez, who's had a couple opportunities. Nothing clear cut. First time ball out of the reach of Shannon Mack straight to Molina. Where Shannon Mack is going, you think she's going to get a goal before it's over. Nutmeg, but Hinkley's can't get to it.
of your Mexico, you got to start to pressure here. You can't just sit back and let the United States keep possession.
They really haven't gotten out of their original shell, even though they're down a pair of goals. They haven't really taken too many chances. And part of the reason could be is because it may be goal difference they need to move on to the next round. They didn't want to open the floodgates and get pounded here. Pam literally held herself onside. It gets through to Shannon Mack. She has a goal. Molina did enough to keep it out. And Molina can be happy about her performance, although her team is still trailing.
Taps closed.
Tell you what, her own defender nearly got one past her. Patty Perez, a deflection. United States have a corner. Looks like they're going to use this opportunity to make another substitution. And one of the surprises on this U.S. roster, Heather O'Reilly is in. A member of the under-19 team that won the inaugural World Cup against Canada, in Canada. Not that long ago, a few weeks. And she replaces Mia Hamm. She can tell her grandkids someday she came on for Mia Hamm. So O'Reilly in, wearing the number 7. Flicked on Molina, another good play.
I'm going to say that ball was out, I guess.
It was, and Gonzalez will take the goal kick. And it looked like it hit the top of the bar before Molina got a touch, but very close. Match, should the scoreline remain the same, would be the second closest result ever between these two countries. The closest, a one-goal affair, 3-2, the U.S. won back in October of 2000. Tell you what, Moore has been certainly very feisty, very pesky on that side. Like she settled in as the match wore on. I think she battled some nerves in the early going, a couple shaky moments. 80th minute, U.S. still looking for that third goal. And Shannon Mack nearly had it on her head. I mean, she comes in and the ball seems to find her in good goal scoring positions.
I think that's just to her credit of making great runs. That ball was just a little bit behind her and caused her to take a step back and hit it over the post.
To hold it. Good turn with McMillan on her back, but she can't get it away. Wagner took a quick look behind her. She lost it, but Hupley's won it back briefly. Vergara trying to spring Dominguez. Look at Joy. Well, she's a full-time mother, but she's still able to get it done. And a key member of this defense between Chastain and Fawcett. Really doesn't matter who you put on the wings because everyone else is going to fall in line. That Kate Sobrero in there, and you got a very good defensive back line. Inside the final 10 minutes. U.S. getting goals from Allie Wagner in the 5th minute. Wagner being pulled right there. And the other from Cindy Parlow, who's since come off in minute 43. Mexico have fought tooth and nail, but they just haven't really been able to threaten this U.S. team on a consistent basis. A couple opportunities on counterattack, but then that's been about it. Here's a 70-year-old Heather Riley. on this Gold Cup team.
In a sense, you're right. I think Mexico is playing for that goal differential.
And you have to give Leonardo Cuellar a little bit of credit. He's got the big picture in hand. Maybe he would admit that on a great day, the U.S. would have to play bad, and Mexico would have to play one of their best matches ever to beat the U.S. But with Panama winning that first match, that's going to throw a wrench in the group. They were the team picked bottom of the four teams in the group. And right now, they're level with the United States on goal difference, although the U.S. haven't allowed a goal. So Mexico have their work cut out for them, that's for sure, in their last two matches against TNT and Panama, but also in some ways, they probably have the better of the schedules because they know now the U.S. is behind them. They have teams they can beat awaiting them. O'Reilly, welcome to the big leagues. Getting a push from Paddy Perez, who hasn't been afraid to mix it up. There's Perez. Speak of the devil, committing the foul on Shannon Mack. He takes the free kick now. Dominguez, not a bad idea. Wagner can't hang on to it. 84th minute. Ball. And too heavy. Takes one bounce and heads over the end line. 85th minute. In the 2000 Gold Cup, Mexico finished third in their group behind China and Canada.
Tough group.
Yeah, very tough group. And their lone win came against Guatemala. They won 7-0 in that match. Coach Heinrichs and Coach Cuellar up next for the U.S. They will take on the Soca Divas of TNT on the 29th in Fullerton. That will be the first match. The nightcap will feature co-group leaders Panama and this Mexico side. Of course, you can catch the entire Gold Cup here on Fox Sports World. I will be here for just about all the matches. Tracy will be here from start to finish. As the United States continue on their journey to the 2003 World Cup back in China. That's where the inaugural Women's World Cup was in 1991, of course, won by the United States. They'll head back to China as defending champions. Coming full circle, some 12 years later, they left the country as champions, and they return as champions. Of course, China doesn't have to qualify as the host country, and they're going to be, of course, extremely difficult to beat, especially on home soil. That may be the difference between them winning the title and someone else holding the trophy aloft.
You can play as a huge advantage, as we saw in the Men's World Cup in Japan.
Yep, absolutely. We saw the South Koreans with tremendous support. And the profile of Asia as a soccer region is certainly being raised because they're hosting of these quadriennial world championships. Good stuff inside the center circle. Vergara. Long long ball. Dominguez will get to it before Scurry. We're looking at the 2003 World Cup in China. As I mentioned, China's in. There'll be two qualifiers from Africa, two from Asia. The third place team from Asia will take on the third place team from the CONCACAF. Here's Shannon Mack getting in shooting range. He knew she was going to pull the trigger. It's blocked. There'll be one qualifier from the Oceania region, two from South America, and you expect Brazil to be certainly one of them. Two teams that reach the final in this Gold Cup will move on. And in Europe, we already know Germany, Norway, Russia, and Sweden are through. And France is halfway there. And they have a second leg against England upcoming in France. So they look good to qualify. It's the fifth team from Europe. So the 2003 World Cup in China beginning to take shape. Here's O'Reilly. That touch got away from her. Has been the power here since 1985 when they played their first full international. But it's actually Mexico that had the first women's national team back in 1970-71. They played in the first two unofficial world championships, if you will. The program took a bit of a hiatus and really kicked in gear once again in the decade of the 90s. Today, looks like the U.S. is going to get better of the matchup. That's a good ball. The header! Molina! Well, you can't say enough about her performance in the second half. She's been the best player on the field.
She's been huge.
Great cross. I don't know if you can get a better save than that from Molina. Euclides denied what she thought was going to be a breakthrough goal. Score now her seven appearances with the national team. Wagner draws the attention of Warbis at the near post. The ball comes in. Euclides, she hit that one well. We're inside the 90th minute. Wagner trying to head it forward more. All the damage the United States did came in half number one, catching teams when they're the most vulnerable at the beginning and at the end of halves. Really, the Sidney Parlow goal looming large because never really allowed Mexico to get into the match. And who knows, had they been chasing only a goal in this half, what would have happened? So you've seen all four teams in this group. We know the U.S. is the heavy favorite. Could have been a handball. But what do you think about Mexico taking on Panama in the next match for both those countries?
I think that'll be a good matchup. I think Panama definitely gained a lot of confidence from their last match. Mexico's going to kind of come in and have to pick their heads up from this match. And I think it'll be tight. I think Mexico may have an edge there on skills and tactical abilities, but I think it'll be a good game.
Well, they're certainly going to have to keep charge and keep track of Damara, who had the hat trick for Panama. When you have a hot goal score, that certainly could be enough to go a long, long way, especially in a tournament like this. Dominguez played it out wide. But that's probably going to be the most important thing. You touched on how Mexico is emotionally. Fawcett there in front of Dominguez. Again, it just depends on what was their expectations coming in. Was it to win this match or was it to play well? I'm sure it was, obviously, you step on to win. But I think they have a healthy dose of respect for the U.S., who's really pounded them over the years. Valderrama, Vergara. But I think Mexico will find a little bit more space against Panama and maybe be able to explode the defense as well. But again, Panama getting the victory and the pressure now being put squarely on the shoulders of Mexico. Another defeat and they can kiss goodbye their dreams of making to their second straight Women's World Cup. Second minute of stoppage time nearly complete. We've had three added on, as you saw. That's a good ball to Mingus. Left-footed shot. Well, she's kept playing.
She's been Mexico's golden force up front.
Yep, she's been going alone quite often. Maybe something Abel Heinrichs will have to focus on. The U.S. defense caught flat a couple times, and that's when Mexico has really had their opportunities to go forward. But the U.S. came into the match, did what they had to do, and they got an early goal and a late goal in the first half. And that really took Mexico out of their game. They had to play catch-up. They just don't have the firepower. Many countries don't. Coming back from behind against the U.S., especially playing at home. Shot, Molina, she can't hang on to it. And Shannon Mack gets her goal. And that will do it for the Rose Bowl. It was a long time in coming. They finally get it, 3-0.
That was a great shot, deflected wide. Shannon McMillan was right there to put it home.
Yep, she was lurking. Only thing Molina hasn't done right in this half. She tried to parry it wide, but she couldn't get it wide enough, and that is it. Shannon Mack with virtually the last kick of the match closes the scoring. The U.S. 3 goals better than Mexico today, and surge on top of Group 1. We'll be back to wrap up the first day of the Gold Cup. Stay with us. At the Rose Bowl in Pasadena and take control of Group 1 as they begin their journey to China 2003 in the World Cup. That's the story. For my producer, Luis Valenzuela, my partner, Tracy Milburn, I've been your host, Alan Hopkins. We thank you for watching Day 1 of the 2002 Gold Cup on the home of world-class soccer, Fox Sports World.
Here for the Handy Stitch, the sewing solution for today that makes sewing fun, fast, and easy.